36 years after his family was ousted from Malacañang, Ferdinand Marcos Jr. finally returns to the palace, this time as the 17th president of the Philippines. Following the tradition of those who came before him, Marcos Jr. first went to Malacañang Thursday morning to meet with his predecessor, Rodrigo Duterte, a symbol of a peaceful transition of power between the incoming and outgoing leaders. Marcos Jr. arrived at the palace a few minutes before 10:30 in the morning, where he was greeted by Duterte on top of the palace staircase. From here, Marcos Jr. signed the palace guestbook, his name and signature being the last entry for the Duterte administration. The mood between the two leaders was cordial and cheerful, despite Duterte calling his successor a spoiled brat and weak leader months earlier. The meeting, however, lasted less than 10 minutes, after which they both descended the grand staircase and into the Kalayaan grounds, where Duterte was given his last honors as President of the Philippines. Had the tradition been followed, the outgoing president would have accompanied his successor all the way to the inaugural venue, where he would be given his last honors, signaling the end of his term and a return to his life as an ordinary citizen. Duterte, however, did not follow this tradition, choosing instead to leave from Malacañang after a quick goodbye to the members of his cabinet. Marcos Jr. then proceeded to the National Museum without his predecessor. In an earlier video, however, Duterte expressed his support for the new administration as he urged the public to help Marcos Jr.
Let us give all our support to the new administration. Tulungan natin. Tulungan natin.
Meanwhile, prior to his return to Davao City on board a commercial flight, the former president spent his first hours as citizen digong by going to a mall in Makati. In returning to his hometown, he is expected to be welcomed back by his supporters through a homecoming concert Thursday night.